Hello, welcome to HellSign episode 7. I'm still sick, but I can't stop playing, so let's continue. Now, that's quite a lot of progress I made in the last few hours because I farmed a lot and I got better at the game, a lot better. And as you can see, I have the Italian special right now. Let me show you on the shops. $3,000. And I also have the assault vest, the best armor so far for me, the paramedics bag, I bought some spectra tripwires and I know how to deal with the ghost and some ammo, and that's about it. Now, as you can see, I don't really have good skills, but I suggest I change my mind about the weapon. So far, I think the pistol is a lot better than the SMG or anything else, because you can just you can upgrade it pretty easy. I mean, look at that, 5% damage and reduce the reload rate with revolver guns, that's amazing. 10% more damage, and again more damage, but with the SMGs and the sound off, well, you have this skill which is almost useless because you get a lot more accuracy, but that doesn't help that much, and almost no damage. So if you would compare the damage, let's say like this, that's 8 damage or 30 bullets, that's 240 damage. How much is this one? 120 damage. So the damage is comparable, but the time you need to reload this, you reload this gun and fire another 10 bullets with it. So actually, that's about 120, 180. And the numbers just don't add up, because you can't really reload this because of some bugs. So the pistol is a lot better, and I'll show you now, because I'll do this mission. I'll just rush it to kill more creatures, so I have a basic understanding on how to kill these creatures and how to avoid them. Again, it's all up to your current gear and your skill set, but usually you could kill almost everything if you are prepared for them. And I still have a lot of things to do in this game, don't worry. I mean, I still have to kill the poltergeists, all three of them, and I still have to do the achievements. Well, most of the achievements are to kill the boss, but there are some hidden ones. The only thing I find really, really annoying are the stupid tentacles that pop out of the ground. The big ones, the fat ones. And they are, because they are too hard to kill, and they will prevent you from escaping sometimes. And they also cheat like that. Yeah, and they also do that. Okay, I'll try to kill some more because I don't want to die when I escape. Okay, I killed a big kraken in the ground, yes. I don't know if that's part of the mission, but oh well. And I don't focus on the sign too much, on the signs too much, because I don't really care about them. This is all about the action. I guess I can get them if I clear the house. What? Nothing to fight yet? Hey, that's not fair. I saw that too. Like, about that thing, I don't know what to do about it. Sometimes it goes away, sometimes it doesn't go away. And I have already lost a lot of health. That's basically. Hey! That was not fair, I was not looking at it. So that was the poltergeist attack. Okay, but no real enemies. I still have to fight about a million blood crawlers. The pistol reloads in under a second. And there, that was almost no damage. Well, a bit of damage because sometimes I can hit them all, but usually I don't take much damage. Okay, that's clear. I really hate this part because they run around and I have to switch target, so I don't really know which one is low in HP. Okay, that could have went better, but what can I say? Okay, let's also that. Well, actually that went too bad because I used the steam pack and that lowered my total health. I didn't want to do that. Okay, now it tells you to place the countermeasure, but the problem is if you place the countermeasures, well, that only cancels the message, but you'll still get a poltergeist. And you'll get it at a random time, so what can I say? I also hope I don't find any locked doors because I haven't been checking out to the clues, so that would be bad. No, not really in the mood for that. I think that door leads to the outside, so wow. Is it gone? Okay, so that's the poltergeist attack. And we survived it, yay! Oh, sometimes I have problems taking the corners. Okay, so is this fully explored right now? Open the door, just stop shooting everything. By the way, the ghouls don't knock me down anymore because I have a lot more stability right now. Come on, game, damn it with the fuck. I'm really starting to think that the stupid SMG is the worst weapon in the game right now because it almost... It's not almost... Okay, I am calm now, I'm very, very calm now. I still think the SMG needs either a buff or something else, because right now, without you having all the skills, they are so bad. I mean, it's not me playing bad, it's the coding of the game, because sometimes it stops firing or sometimes it doesn't reload all the way. And the dev sure will get on that, because it's getting on my nerves. I mean, look at this. And then... This is how it works perfectly, but in a combat situation this won't happen. And we had that almost done. Okay. That was a premature. Okay, so this was better because I didn't lose any maximum health because I didn't use my steam packs. Nice. So this is how you're supposed to use the SMG. I mean, burst for something, and then the other thing you just have to. Okay, for the boardlock barrels. Don't try to reload your weapon. Just switch to your secondary weapon. Well, that went a lot better right now. Again, let's be max health. And now let's check our surrounding because I totally am off guard. So we started right there. I think that's the way out. So that's not a room. Oh, that's a room. Okay, so I need to find the key for that. And this is the boring part of the game because I'm probably okay, I'll just show you this to you. Okay, so it's on the other side of the wall. So as you can see, my investigating game has... Okay... Let's not risk it because they are so buggy right now. Because they can pass through walls and you can't. And the range on the only thing bad about the pistol is that the range is sometimes not very sure. I mean, sometimes it's long range, sometimes it's medium range, but on its description it says it's medium range. So medium range is about this big, I think. Long range is a full screen almost. Some Coca-Cola for luck. And I hate this. What? Really, game, really? Next time I'll get grenades and just blow everything up. When I level up next time I'll just get those grenades and throw them at everybody, because this is getting out of hand. I mean, some of these maps are really ridiculous, especially the spiders, because you don't really have room to fight the spiders. I mean, I don't mind a good challenge like the Shadow Beast or the Blood Crawlers, but well, you can't really run away from them because they'll just charge you and damage you. I don't know what to say about that. They should really look into it. I don't really feel like fighting them now. Let's see what we have here. Whether we can target that. see if we can find an easy sign. Nope, can't find it. And I really wish they would add a map, because without a map, and even if it's as a skill or something else, without a map the game becomes very, very hard to play sometimes. Because the design of the houses can be so different and so radically... so radically different and so, I don't know, annoying or something like that. Excuse me. I can't get into that door. For why? For what reason? Is that door locked? Oh, come on, game. Okay, okay. Let's adapt. Don't be angry. That's not a bug, that's the game. Well, no, that was a bug. And when the poltergeist is like that, I mean, it wants to attack you and eat your soul, you're better off just not exploring and just searching for signs. But me being me, I can help myself and I'll do it anyway. Also, they give a false positive signal sometimes if you're not good. Well, I'm dead. Okay, it also triggered the tripwire, but it also damaged me. So that's what happens. I think if you don't have enough health or armor, it will one-shot you. It did that to me one time or another. Okay, where did I come from? Where did I go? Okay, there is not an easy sign here and I have to use the thermal. I'm just searching for items that can be a key because I don't want to be stuck in... Okay, let's just forget about that. I think the next thermal skip. They will sometimes flank you like that. So the best weapon when dealing with them is still again the pistol. But also the SMG or the machine gun, depending on how long you have been playing. Okay, so I searched everything right here. I guess the biggest challenge for me is still the spider right now. Either you can hear the sounds even if you don't check it with your microphone. Okay, let's reload because I may need those bullets. Okay, the ghouls are out of the way now, just I'll just hope I don't meet the Spider Queen, because Spider Queen, Spider Mother, Spider, regular Spider. Because that's the one thing I really hate about the game right now, the Spider. The Spider Mother. Because she. It's frequently very hard to dodge her. And she'll just chain hit you like that. Oh, that's another one, and it's locked behind the door. That's stupid. Stop chain hitting me like that, you cruel spider thingy. And this spider can actually kill you very fast. I think there is one left. Okay, that wasn't so bad, but there is still one left and I don't have enough medicine. Well, okay, I'm full health. And I'll probably need another. Okay, I still think I have the blood tentacle and another spider crawler. Oh, and those. Okay, let's search for the key right now. Might as well get some sense if you're still here, and this is the last I'll do for this. And this is how basically the end gameplay is. Okay, the dead body is right there. It's on the other side. Phew, this was pretty intense. Now let's follow the signs of that dead body. They are still a little hard to get and a hard. I mean, everything right now seems to just waste your time. And there are still some problems with intersecting tracks that can really throw you off game. And also that stupid thing which I really hate, because that thing will. Oh, come on, game. Do you kill that stupid thing? Okay, let's just find the key somewhere else. Nice, I like it when the ghosts are on the toilet. Or the towel, like, even better. Okay, there's something there. Well, UG port, that's not good, but also not that bad. Was that in game? Okay, the game has a lot of those events that will just scare you. I don't want to go there because that thing will attack me and just chip away at my health. And I still have a mother spider to fight in here. Okay, something right here. Could be. Stop that, stop that. So this is why my light was flickering the other time. If your reliability is low, some mission types we can't even do. because you can't find items in them. Oh great, that's just great, thank you. And I have to get the next level one to be able to use this without the static, because that's all the black light was flashing for me. Oh, this game sometimes. So how many signs I find? It's five, only 5 out of 9. That's particularly terrible. Okay, that's parasitic or vampiric, I think. I guess I'll summon the banshee the last time so we can see it, but... Stop that immediately. And the thermal detector is still a bit clunky and hard to use because of all the static, and I really hate it because everything will slow you down, and by slowing you down you will have less chances of winning. And now I even forgot where my car is, because that's how the game actually likes to play. Am I cold here? No, not cold. Actually, I could just do it like this. Yeah, I'll just do it like this. Nice, I found the key. Now that spider will destroy me. Now, to open a door with a key... was it F? Yes, it's F. Press F, the same button you use for this one, the black light, and then... They are still a bit RNG because sometimes they will split up in weird directions. And I didn't get a complete mission. Well, I guess I have to kill the tentacles outside, but those are way above my current health. Yes, I need to practice some more and maybe get those grenades, because these types of enemies are really, really annoying. But at least I want to get one more sign if I can. So at least I get money out of this. The problem is that I don't even think I'll make it to the van, because those tentacles will rip me to shreds. So this is basically the whole house explored, but maybe I have to kill those things as well, those tentacles. But I really don't have any entry on them. Those things in the wall, I mean. Well, I guess this mission is a lot harder than I thought, and I'll do it off camera because this is too random and too RNG in my opinion. So only 5 out of the possible 9, because I don't know, I couldn't find the thermal ones, and I didn't want to try more of that. But look at that, 1300 experience, $2,020, 15 minute mission. But we can also go to the bar and see how much money we really get. Okay, so do it like this. That triggered once. Okay. And now let's try to set an expensive one. Well, that didn't really trigger when I wanted to, but again, that's a lot more money than you might have think. Might have thought. So let's unlock our grenades, because I think this is going to be a lot harder without the grenades, because I really want to use those grenades against those caterpillars things. 50% more damage to hand grenades, that's a lot of more damage. Well, that's new. At this point of the game, I basically don't care about the money, I just want to finish those things. This does almost no damage, so don't bother with them. Let's have 10 grenades. Non-letal UV locating black light signs, okay. I'll buy some of them, and also the... Okay, the... actually, the rotten meat. Dynamite, okay, I can't use that. And let's go to our howitzer. And let's see where our grenades are. Nice, so this is our grenade slot, a cluster grenade. Well, let's see how they play and then we'll end the video. Let's just do a little sweeping mission. And let's see how fast we can do it. Wow, I can't finish a mission like the haunting, but it all depends on the monsters that I have to fight. I mean, those tentacles outside, I still haven't found a good tactic to destroy them all. And they will basically one-shot you if they hit you. Actually, no, they would have killed me if they hit me once on that particular game. I guess I just need to practice more with handling them and the spiders, because the spiders and them, those outside tentacles are my biggest problem right now. Oh, leave me alone, you're too low level for me right now. What's the key for them? Oh, they don't explode when thrown, they explode on contact. Okay, let's see how it does. Today, not triggered. Proximity mines, but the ghouls are big enough to trigger them, right? Well, I guess they are not. Oh, you guys really want to kill me now. Okay, I'll just throw more on the ground and see what sticks. Okay, let's get a few blood crawlers out. Come on, little blood. You're not a blood crawler. Oh, come on. So as you can see, the game's armor system is basically a reduced incoming damage by this much. Are they not working? Well, I guess they're not working. Ah, let's just throw them all away. Blood crawlers then? What combat again? The game is still a bit buggy sometimes, and that's not, well, that's not a problem for me. So I really, on the next episode we'll learn how to use grenades. I'll probably do that mission of Camel and tell you how it went, because sometimes you get a bad map, sometimes you get a good map. Is somebody moving this? By the way, look at the details of this game. As you can see, the bullet is falling and the sound it makes is right when it hits the floor. That's good details in my opinion. Okay, so this has been this for this episode, and as you can see, pistols are a lot better now. And you can use the shotgun as your main weapon if you really want it, and I guess this is the main thing for the beta, pistols and not SMGs. Or SMGs are good for a fast run if you want to blaze through the content, like the sweeping and the scouting missions. Okay, that's still bugged, I can still hear a lot of them. Okay, see you next time, bye bye.